Now we are going to cover how to create a BAP query. So we are going to this transaction SQVUI. Okay. So if you notice this query I have already created, we are going to create another brand new query. Okay. So the first thing you have to give is you click on the quick view and you give a name. So I'm giving you here, I'm creating Z quick view test Z test 13. Okay, and then you click on this create button. Once you click this create button, where we will give a title, here we have to give vendor details. Okay, by business partner. This is a new concept that has come in S4HANA, the business partner, which was previously only used for customer. Now it's going to be used for both customer and vendor. Now here we can mention the data source. So we'll do so most of the time you want to do it through table join. Logical database, you can use it for things like especially on the HR front where they have a lot of logical database. SAP query info set is mostly used for the BWPs where you can create queries based on those means info set, where you can create a set of tables. But for now, what we are going to do is we'll be using table join. Okay, and here you can select the basis mode. So generally I always go for basis mode. You can search with the layout mode, and then you click on the green arrow here. Now here, once we have created, this is the place where everything comes. Okay, now first thing you have to do is you have to insert a table. So I'm going to insert a table, IBP supplier. Okay, I've done the research. So if you want, you can do a search. So IBP supplier is the table that is heavily used to maintain the relationship between a business partner and the vendor. Okay, so here I double click on it and I click on the continue button. Okay, and now I have to add another table. Okay, so here I will put, suppose, LFA1. Okay, and this is the table for vendor master. Okay, so I have entered this. Now I will do another, I'll put another table because I want to know the pay terms of the vendors. Okay, so I'll do an LFB1. Okay, and this, so these are the selections I have done. Now notice here, this is the joining that SAP is proposing. That's not correct because I want to do the join on supplier to Lifner. So you can always do like this. You can drag this and put it here. Okay, here once we have dragged it, it's working. You can always click on the syntax. There's no syntax error. So here we have created the joining condition. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to go back. That's the most. So this is the joining condition is done. That means the logic has been delivered. Now we have to select the number of fields. Now here, if you notice, these are fields that has the field level. Now based on whether you're a functional or you know the field name, it makes sense sometimes to put the technical names. To in order to get the technical name, you have to just click on this. It says switch between technical name and long text. So once you do that, you see this is the thing that comes. Now what you will be doing is you click on IBP supplier, and this is the business partner, and I'll get some other information, supplier account. Okay, now I'm going down, completely down, because I want information from vendor master LFA1, which is important. I want to get some more information. So I'll get the land, the name. So the first name is fine for me. And then I want to get some street address and other information. Okay. Now, as I said before, I want to get information on the payment terms. So what I can do is I'm scrolling down. If you see, whenever I reach LFB1, that's the company code data table for vendor. So I'm already there. What I can do is for LFB1 here, I can put the company code, which is Bookers, and here I can put the, here there would be something pay terms, okay, and I'll put the pay method also, okay. And these are the things I've done, so I'll just move it here, okay. And if you notice, so this is the layout, that's the output that we are going to get to run this query. Now we have to put the selection screen. As I said, the selection screen, you need to have one. So what I'm going to do, I'll put the account number, the vendor partner number, I'll put it here, okay. And probably what I can do is I can put the accounting group. Now if you scroll down, I'll take the company code from. Now if you want to search stuff, so you can search from here, okay. So suppose I am here trying to find company code. So let's go. I don't want this company. Company size. There is the company code. Okay. And just to make sure, be sure that this is the correct one, LFB one. So this is the one that I want. Okay. Now here it is. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to save it. So once this save, this is warning. As SAP says, warning you can ignore, okay. Warning and information you can ignore, okay. That's my thing for working for 14 years in SAP. That's what I came to know, okay. Now if you execute, now let's execute, and what I'll be doing is probably I'll give a company code DE00. That's what I know, okay. And we'll execute. We'll see. See, here it gave me all the vendors, the business partner, the name, and the company code. So here I can see all this information. So you can see different vendor numbers that got created and all those things. So this gave me all the things. Now, if you want to add more stuff in the layout, you can get it. So that covers everything based on how to create a ABAP query from scratch.